Nuzvid is a historical town in Andhra Pradesh, India. An American missionary, Dr. T.R. Flez, negotiated a trust agreement between Sri Rajashobhanadri Apparao, the zamindar of Telaprol, for 5 acres of land, 5 uncompleted buildings, and 10,000 rupees. The wish of the donor was to name the hospital after his friend, Gifford, an officer in the British Army. In the year 1925, the Gifford Mission Hospital was established to improve the quality of life in and around Nuzvid by praying, praising, healing, and preparing for Christ's return. Since 1925, Gifford Memorial Hospital has facilitated the establishment of about 150 Seventh-day Adventist churches, making it a center of influence. Thousands were baptized, accepting the truth. The hospital chaplain and the nursing staff visit the inpatients and pray for their speedy recovery and well-being. The village ministry is a special initiative of the hospital staff who visit the patients to strengthen their faith. Over 80 villages surround Nuzvid with a total population of 865,741, of which sadly, over 97% are non-believers, and only a mere 2% are Christians. This staggering number of non-Christians echoes a verse from the scriptures. The harvest is plenty, but the laborers are few. Pray ye therefore the Lord of the harvest, that he would send forth laborers into his harvest. Every single patient comes trusting that our hospital is an abode of healing. Likita, a 10-year-old female child, came to GMH with severe respiratory distress. When I was not able to breathe, the doctors treated me with love. They gave me oxygen. I was pricked so many times to check my blood sugar, but I did not feel any pain. They took care of me so well that you can see that I am delighted and healthy. I am grateful to them. Though I was discharged, I did not want to leave the hospital as it felt like home. Ever since its inception, GMH shone God's grace and brought smiles, healing, and growth. The eye department is one of the busiest and the most charitable wing of the hospital. Many receive sight and can see again. Over 16,113 cataract surgeries were performed during the past 5 years. The vision of over 99% patients was restored, allowing them to have a better view of life.
Patient who was actually got arrested, cardiac arrest. We revived, now the patient is breathing and we praise God for that. The patient was brought here with the hope of healing, but sadly we are referring the patient to a higher center due to unavailability of critical care services. They are left with no option except risking their life to travel to Vijayawada, which is 50 kilometers away.
Emotions are stretched to the point of breaking. Yet the staff, with compassion on their faces, served the sick. When we took him to another hospital, the doctor said that he would die soon. When we brought him to this hospital, without even taking a single penny, they started the treatment immediately. And I would say hats off to Dr. Edwin and the nursing staff for reviving the patient who's dead. We'll be ever grateful to them throughout our lives for the second life they gave to my brother. Sadly, we encounter cases of poisoning, the majority of them related to financial problems and snake bites almost every day. I was bitten by a snake and was semi-conscious. They planned to take me to the government hospital, but I was pleading with them to take me to GMH, the American hospital. I was praying in my heart for the situation that I was in. It broke my heart when I thought of my children and husband, thinking about what would happen if I lose my life. The next day, I woke up at 5 a.m. I opened my eyes and saw a Bible verse on the wall, and then realized that I was alive. When I saw the verse on the wall, I said, "Lord, these verses have saved me." I asked God, "Who are these people in white clothes?" The nurses appeared like angels around me. If not for God's will, this would not have happened to me. Moreover, I am grateful to God for this life. We've had situations when we were forced to close the casualty and referred patients to a tertiary center due to the lack of modern facilities and availability of beds. The present ICU has only one ventilator to handle critical cases. It's a difficult decision to turn down the admission of critical patients due to the limited facilities. But that is the harsh reality. It was the challenges of childbirth and the non-availability of an NICU within a radius of 25 kilometers and the increasing neonatal mortality rate that inspired Dr. Edwin to set up a neonatal ICU, providing support for the mothers and for the babies born in GMH, the primary healthcare centers around, and babies born at home. Baby Jenny was 33 weeks preterm with a birth weight of 900 grams and was struggling for life. I am Durga Bhavani. The reason for my smile is GMH. Before this baby, I lost two babies, one male and one female. I took this baby to several hospitals, but I was told that the baby wouldn't survive. So I came to this hospital with some hope. Dr. Edwin was instrumental in restoring the life of my baby, who was weighing in grams. Even during delivery, I had high blood pressure. The doctors told me that the chances of survival of my baby were very, very slim. I am pleased today because of the doctors and the medical staff at GMH. This is my baby. I am happy because of my baby. I will ever remain grateful and indebted to Gifford Memorial Hospital. The NICU was started a year ago, bringing smiles on the faces of the mothers and with so much to offer. Being in a rural setting, the majority of patients were farmers and daily wage earners. Others who visit the hospital are from the lower economic background. Here you can see Dr. Edwin and the neonatal nurses working hard, resuscitating a baby who was brought to the hospital in an unresponsive state. This baby's precious life could not be saved. It was heartbreaking to see the agony of the father, who says there's a delay in the lack of transportation in bringing the baby to the hospital on time, which would have given us the chance to save the child. Therefore, the hospital has envisaged augmenting the existing facility by increasing the bed capacity of the ICU and NICU and complementing it with life-saving medical equipment and the purchase of a mobile clinic van which can reach the sick and bring them for treatment. The hospital also plans to increase the number of theaters, start a dialysis unit, strengthen the diagnostic facilities with the addition of CT scan and MRI facilities. It will be a blessing to have dedicated missionary doctors who are willing to lend their hand in the medical ministry and support the work that God has commissioned to do here at Noseweed. As with every patient that comes to GMH, the focus is on excellence in care, ethical service, and clear communication. The survival of 900-gram baby Jenny was a success, and the family returned home. praising God happily. The number of poisoning cases returning home with their precious lives. Thousands returned with their vision restored. GMH is proud in doing its part in taking the Seventh-day Adventist message forward. Whether it's the wonder of the new life or the tragedy of the sick. GMH is deeply committed to manifest the love of God and proclaim the three angels' message to prepare them for the soon coming of Jesus Christ. We treat, Jesus heals.